In this session, we will explore the advanced use of animation in SPUM. Let's assume we are creating a character through SPUM, a soldier of a specific class. First, let's run a random selection to pick an appropriate design. I like the design of this soldier. He is currently holding an axe. So when he moves, he will move like this. When an attack is made, it shows an animation of swinging an axe like this. I will change this soldier from holding an axe to holding a bow. Delete the existing weapons and select the bow. And the decoration was changed to an arrow being carried on the back. At this point, when you press attack, it plays attack normal, taking the basic attack motion. If you choose attack bow instead of attack normal at this time, you will see the character shooting arrows. Therefore, let's delete the animations that are not being used. By clicking close, you can now confirm that this soldier has the appearance of an archer. Let's save this, and then try to create a spearman. Keep rolling the random option until you get the desired design. Shall we create an undead spear soldier this time? After selecting a person, we choose the undead appearance and make modifications to the design ourselves. A cool undead soldier has been created, and now I will give this undead soldier a spear. Currently, this undead soldier is holding a spear, but it does not have animations specialized for the spear, from basic idle animations to movement and attack. So, let's change the animations to ones that suit a spear soldier, using the animations provided by default. First, click on the idle, and select Add New Clip at the bottom. Then, animations provided for each add-on version will appear in the list, and at the bottom, you will see the long spear underscore idle. This animation is a basic animation clip made to better suit a spearman. Select this animation clip, and deselect 0 underscore idle, and if you check, you will see that the animation clips for the spearman character are playing as shown below. In the same way, you can add new clip to the move and remove the existing move. Then select the long spear underscore work and press close to see a skeleton soldier walking with movements that fit better with the spearman. I will also change the attack in the same way. The attack basically includes regular attacks, arrow attacks, and magic attacks, but I will delete all of these and select the long spear attack provided in version 3 from the default animations. Then, you can see a thrusting attack that fits better with the spearman. And when you press close, you can now see this soldier playing an animation that matches the spearman. I'll save it. Next, we have the feature that uses animation presets. This feature has been available since version 1.7.0 and does not exist in previous versions. To use this feature, first select the prefab you have created. Then select the unit you have made, and click on the Animation Preset tab. Then a window will appear as shown below, and by clicking the Add button, you can create the animation preset you want. By clicking the small name change icon, you will be able to type in a name. I will name it Spear, press the Enter key, and save this part. Now, when I want to create a new unit, assign a Spear Soldier to it, and apply animations. Even if you don't edit everything, you can choose from the animation preset. If you select the preset, you can easily make it a spearman. Also, this method cannot be used only when creating a character. Create a character, save it, press load unit. It's also possible to apply it to pre-made characters. Click batch process mode at the bottom. Click on the unit you want to change. Then, select the pre-made animation preset in the bottom right corner, and click apply preset to confirm that. The pre-made animation has been applied as shown below. Through the following methods, it is also possible to easily apply animation to various units according to the bottle you have made. Once the organization of the units is complete, you can press the placement process mode to close it. That concludes today's discussion on animation settings and the animation preset feature. In the next session, we will cover how to create animations directly in the SPUM. Please look forward to the next video. Thank you.